Shayna and Keith will come with us to Halloween Horror Nights just because they love seeing me and Jessamyn Duke run, scream, jump, hide, all of that.
Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. And today on Superstar Save Point, we have the fantastic, incredible Mia Yim! Woo!
An entrance. Thank you. Thank you.
How's it been going? What you been up to this quarantine?
I've been twitching a lot. I've been video editing and spending a lot of time with my dog. It's great.
Yep. Hell yeah. All right. Today we're going to play Alien versus Predator while I ask you a bunch of questions.
So will you still be my friend if I told you I've never watched Alien or Predator?
Oh, 100%. 100%. Okay, so cool. Be your friend. Yeah, I do feel like it's like a rite of passage to watch these movies, but if you haven't, uh-huh, that means that you got your to-do list built in already.
I guess. I remember the last time I told Shelton, he stopped texting me for a while, so.
Well, I won't be like Shelton. You guys have a very unique relationship.
Well, you're already better than him, so I know you wouldn't be the same.
I appreciate it. I'm gonna go with Predator.
I want Lynn. Perfect.
For the people that don't know about how you and Shelton are with each other, can you tell them how you guys got to where you currently are today?
Well, so we originally met, it was like 2010, 2011, at an indie show. And of course there was a catering table with wings on it. So the first thing I went for was the wings, and he went for the wings, and we just started talking then and kept a friendship since then. And it's everything from like the big brother, little sister component to like when everything serious happened in my life, he was there, and he's just always been the same. He's never changed. He's always been the diva, bougie man, and I'm the one that's trying to get him out of that habit. But for someone so bougie, he's really cheap. He's a penny pincher.
Yeah.
So
I didn't know about y'all's rivalry until like, I don't know what, maybe like 2 years ago, we were overseas and you made some comment on Twitter. He said something about losing or having kids or something. And you shot back at him with the hardest insult ever. And I was dying. And then I asked Shelton about it. He's like, oh yeah, this is how we are with each other.
Yeah. We try to take every opportunity, especially on Twitter and Instagram, just to throw jabs at each other. But it makes it a lot easier now that I get to see him on a regular in WWE. Ooh, how do I pick that up? There we go. So before, all we had was seeing each other at random indie shows and communicating through social media. So now it's like, I could say all this trash on social media, and then next week I could easily just see him and pick it right back up. it's been an ongoing thing for years.
Yeah, that's the kind of stuff that keeps you going, and I don't think people realize it. Like,
the best part is when people think that we're serious, so we get people literally on each other's sides, and it's like, if they only knew.
This is like my best friend. Oh my god. So you also said throughout the quarantine times, so you've been on Twitch a lot. I've seen you all around Twitch. Like, what are you playing? What got you into it? What's the deal?
So I've been thinking about what I said earlier before we went live. Ever since you came to the PC to have that meeting at the performance center, it's always just been in the back of my mind, like, oh, maybe that's something, you know, I could get into because I see you do it all the time. I see Jay Duke do it all the time. And it wasn't until quarantine had just started and I was with Keith and I was playing, I want to say Resident Evil 2 or 3. And he was just watching me play and he was just like, why don't you stream? Like, you play video games already. And it was like, always my reasoning behind never really picking it up was because of the schedule. It's just, I never had time to really sit and look into getting a PC and things like that. So it was like, okay, now I actually have time to do my research, looking into things. I got the resources with Jay Duke and reaching out to you about, you know, getting this PC. And it's just being able to finally have the time to do my research and get everything set up, because everything with my Twitch and my YouTube, like I did everything on my own. So it was just having the time to do it all. So I wish I would have gotten into it a lot earlier, but I am loving Twitch. I'm loving being able to interact with fans that I'm unable to because we're not doing shows anymore.
Yep.
So that, I think that's like my favorite part, is just keeping in contact with everyone that I would normally see at a show. It's like, okay, I can actually talk to them virtually now. But
You switched character.
Oh, I did?
You did.
Oh. Okay. Oops. Whatever. Okay.
It happens.
Yeah. I can adapt.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, see, drop the people's elbow too. All right. I like this guy already.
I feel like this works. But yeah, just that banter. So like I've gotten that feeling definitely. So like, we play Uno a bunch on the channel. I see you've been dipping into Uno too on Twitch.
Always, yeah.
Playing with the there you
Uno's
go.
A classic.
But we noticed, like, just having that little bit of time to sit and play Uno with each other, you know, once a week, it definitely works wonders for your like morale about how 2020 is going.
Absolutely. It was getting to a point where it was like, I started hating quarantine. Like, I wanted to go out, go to the gym, just leave the house, which I know we shouldn't be doing, but like, it was just getting stir crazy. So getting into Twitch and YouTube, it's like, finally I get to stay at home and stay occupied with something new, fresh, finally getting able to chat with different people every day. So Twitch has definitely saved me from doing some real stupid things.
Twitch is saving lives out here.
For sure.
So yeah, so you see playing Uno on there sometimes with subs. Like, what else are you playing on there?
So I have been playing, so I finished The Last of Us 2, which I didn't really care for. The first Last of Us was so much better. In my opinion.
Yeah.
All right, now I'm playing Ghost of Tsushima, which I am I'm already considering it my 2020 game of the year.
What? Really?
Yeah, I'm in love with that game. Oh, that's what we're supposed to do.
Yeah.
So it's like, it reminds me of Assassin's Creed, but I've always loved the Japanese culture. So it's cool to have a mix of Assassin's Creed and Japan.
Yeah.
So I'm just loving the samurai aspect, the assassinations aspect, like just a fighting adventure, horse riding. Like, riding the horse reminds me of Red Dead 2. So it's like a mix of everything that I love into this one game. And it's like, I can play this game for the rest of the year and I'll be happy.
So you mentioned Red Dead. So are you big into Red Dead as well?
I am obsessed with Red Dead. This year for Halloween, I think I'm going to be Sadie Adler. So I actually played it opposite. So I got into Red Dead 2. I never even heard of Red Dead until... Mm-hmm. When it originally came out, and Jessamyn Duke and Shayna was just raving about it. So I'm like, okay, if it's as good as they say, let me get this game and just see how it is. And that's actually the game that got me back into gaming. Cause I used to be big into gaming in high school, but after getting into wrestling, that was just my focus. I never really had time for gaming anymore. So, playing Red Dead 2 got me back into gaming. So it wasn't just the gameplay either, which was beautiful on its own. I loved the story. Absolutely. It was the first game, I want to say ever, that made me cry.
Really?
So yeah, I was so invested, and the story was just so emotional that for Christmas that year, Keith gave me the first Red Dead that I could play on my Xbox. So I played Red Dead 2, which was the prequel anyway, into the first Red Dead. And it was like the best story ever, which Red Dead 1 also made me cry as well. I was just already invested in all the characters and knowing their backgrounds and everything. Just Red Dead as a whole series. Like, I know right after I finished both, it's like, okay, when's the next Red Dead coming out? It's like, oh, it took a decade for the second one to come out. So I'm like, damn, now I have to actually wait.
Yeah, we were waiting a little bit for that one. I can't imagine playing it that way.
It was, so I didn't even know it was a prequel. Oh my God, why is this? I didn't even know it was a prequel. So I'm thinking everything was, you know, I just skipped ahead. But when Jessamyn Duke told me that, you know, it's really the second one is the first game, and then you know, the first one is the second game. It's like, okay, let me. Oh my God,
you see what let me.
Yeah, so like, I just went into it blind. I didn't even know what Red Dead 2 was about. I legit just went about it just by word of mouth with Shayna and Jessamyn. And I've never really been a fan of like Western style, like shows, movies, anything like that. So just starting the game was like, okay, this is cool. Like, this is all right.
If you hit select, then, hit, oh, there you go. There you go.
Got it.
And then if you want to, okay, go. Gotcha. Dope.
Oh my God. Sorry, I completely lost my train of thought.
Oh, no, you're good. You're talking about Red Dead, Shayna and Jessamyn told you about it.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for them, you wouldn't have played it.
Right. So I've never been a fan of Westerns, but like the graphics felt like a movie. And it's like, okay, I'm invested. Let's see how this is. And it's from the story.
Yeah. So when I played it, I did all the stuff in the snow and the prologue's super long and you're riding the horse forever. Mm-hmm. And for me, like, I was like, oh my God, just get to where you're going. I couldn't do the horse riding stuff. But everybody that I talk to that really likes it, they always talk about how good the story is. And it makes me mad that I didn't sit down and actually take the time.
Wait, you didn't?
No, because I got through that first like prologue thing. And once I got to the first town, my save messed up, so I had to start over. So I was like, I can't do this beginning part again. I can't walk through the snow for 35 minutes again. But
You have to finish it. It is definitely worthwhile. Like, I think I like those kind of games where it's not straight action 24/7. Like, you actually have time to just enjoy the view and just go on a stroll with your horse. And like, I like that kind of stuff. Like, when I played Death Stranding, it was a lot, like the first couple hours was just walking through the mountains, which I like that kind of stuff. So it was very easy to get through the beginning bits and just, you know, right before the action, kind of just enjoy just the gameplay a little bit.
Yeah. Can you hit share for me?
Oh, damn.
Yeah, hit it a few times.
Share.
There we go. So now we got some credits. Perfect.
Okay.
All right.
My bad.
No, you're good. You're good.
But I would highly recommend you finish the story. At least the story. Like, I didn't get into the online, but then again, when I did play online, it was beta. So I haven't been on the online Red Dead game in a while. But even the online as a beta wasn't even bad, because me and Jay Duke would just be in a posse and we would like to fish and run them up with randoms.
Yeah. I guarantee you there's a bunch of people who play online who would love to have you as part of their posse.
I gotta get back into it.
Yeah.
The problem for me is I wish I got it for PlayStation. I got it for Xbox, and I haven't turned all my Xbox in.
Oh.
Ever. I only play Xbox when I'm playing with the girls. Oh, hey, boy.
Yeah. Always up.
Yeah, okay, he's so awake now.
Yeah. All right. So, are open world games more of your thing?
Yeah, I think so. As long as I stay focused on the story, like I get distracted a lot by side missions. I think that's one of the things with Ghosts is that I'm just doing a bunch of side missions. But when I'm really invested in the story, that's all I want to do. So whether it's like Death Stranding or Ghosts, Red Dead, Grand Theft Auto, like if I'm invested in the story, then that's what's the winner for me is. Like I don't really care too much about just beat 'em up type games and just gore and whatever. It's like, give me a good story that I can invest in the characters and you have me sold forever.
Yes. And see, so everyone watching, that's why we normally play beat 'em ups when we do these episodes, because it's much easier to just mash buttons and talk.
Touché. Granted, I am really good at button mashing.
You said something about Grand Theft Auto. I love Grand Theft Auto and started to get into the online a few months ago with some friends, because there's so much stuff you can do. So much.
I gotta try out the online, because I've been told that the online gameplay has been awesome, but I've just never gotten into, I never even started up online.
So you can rob banks and stuff, but like it's like 9-part plan. So like first part of the mission, you gotta go get the airplane with a couple people, and then you go back to your safe house and you can do whatever. And then a few minutes later, another thing will open up where now you take that plane to go do something else, and then you have to go to a prison steal an outfit. And it's like, as you do all the missions, you see all the things you gain, and then you use all those things to go like rob the bank. And it's
that's so
freaking
cool.
Awesome. It's freaking awesome.
I think I'm gonna have to try it now.
Yes.
We got the whole gang now.
Yes, we're coming through. So you've been on Twitch during quarantine. You're playing Ghost right now and absolutely loving it. As far as so the games that you mentioned, and you're talking about like at one point, did you say Rockstar games?
Yes.
We're on. Yeah, we're talking about Rockstar. when you say they always produce like some good, like sink your teeth intoable stuff.
Oh yeah, for sure. Like I am playing back and forth between Ghost, and if I wanted to switch it up a little bit, I've gone back and play L.A. Noire. Like it's an older game, but I'm like, I've never played it, and it was on sale on the PlayStation Store. I was like, okay, let me try it. Like anything with Rockstar is amazing, so I've gotten into it, and I just love Rockstar. Like. They're never disappointing. And so it's like, I'm thinking it was gonna be another like a old school LA Grand Theft Auto, like San Andreas, but it's a whole different feel. The fact that like, I love the ID channel, like just investigations and things like that. And it's like, this is my favorite. I love this. I get to interrogate people and fight crime, and like this is amazing.
the facial thing where you got to see if they're lying or not, based on the facial that they make. It's like, what is this?
Yeah, it's like one of those things where I'm like, okay, this is gonna be easy. Like my dad taught me from the jump how what it means when a person's lying, and if they're shifting their eyes one way, they're telling the truth. I'm like, okay, I got this. Nope, I got a reality check. I was like, I need all the help I can get right now.
I get so mad because you do a mission and you get 96% of the way done, and then you go back.
Yes!
Because you missed this one lie. So you go back and play this whole 3 hours over again if you want 100%. But I have to.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a hell of a game.
I don't even think I got like 100% yet on a mission. Like
it gets hard.
I think I just got to I'm at the point now where I'm in the murder investigative part rather than, I think, like the burglaries and robberies. So now it's starting to get hard.
Moving up the ladder.
On my Twitch, I do this thing called like a scary game goal. So it's like either an Outlast goal or Resident Evil, because I am terrified of scary games. Mm-hmm. It's way too immersive, and it's like scary movies with me, though. Like, I love scary movies, but I can't do it alone. So doing it on Twitch, it's like, okay, now I can get through these scary games that I really like, because I'm technically not alone.
Yeah.
But like, I've been playing Outlast and Resident Evil 7 Biohazard, I think. Mm-hmm. And it gives me nightmares.
Yes.
I remember when I first played Resident Evil, like, just by myself with Keith. He's like, you have to stream this. Like, you're too entertaining to not stream this. I'm like, I don't want people to see me an actual chicken with their game. But here I am now, just having to. Yeah.
It's like, you realize I have to look tough to these people later, right? I have to try to look as tough as possible to them later.
Right. I can't do it. I can't do it.
Have you played Resident Evil in VR yet?
Hell no.
That's what you need to do. That's what you need to do.
I know you got me messed up to even record that. J-Duke gave me her VR set and everything, and I'm like, you can leave it in my room, but I ain't touching it. I am not touching it.
You absolutely have to. If that's not a goal by next week, I'm gonna be so upset.
Damn it. That is terrifying. Just that one part in Biohazard where the girl's crumbing up the stairs and she just pops up. I'm like, there's no way. Because everyone's like, you should play it in VR. I'm like, there's no way. You gotta pay me a lot of money for that.
I played it through, no VR. And then I tried it VR for maybe 10 minutes. And as soon as the first thing jumped at me, I like tossed the headset off. Like I couldn't do it. It's close enough on the screen, but when it's right here on my face.
Hell no. I did I played Dread Halls with VR on with Jessamyn Duke, and like just that experience. like you're in a dark hall, and I wanted to literally run away, but how our house was, it's like, if you moved out of the VR square, like you're going to go down some steps. And it's like, I would rather tumble down than deal with this game in VR. I cannot imagine freaking Resident Evil.
Hell yeah.
Oh my God.
Hell yeah. It'd be so good. There's another good one. So Song of Horror is really cool. It's on Steam. So you're like, this guy gets like sucked into a wall in his house, and it takes him like another dimension. And there's a couple of different characters you can be, and you have to go into the house and like try to find him. It's the first stage, but certain things happen. Like there's like this evil, like dark goop that's in the house, and it's like whatever possessed thing or evil thing. And so before you go into doors, you have to listen to see if you can hear it. And so the game gets super quiet, and you either hear this like, or you don't hear anything. But if you walk into it, you get swallowed up. And so when I would play it, I'd have it on like, oh, if you put in X amount of bits, it'll make this loud scream in my headphones. So every time I'd go to listen to hear if I hear that noise, they would throw that in, and it would scream, and it'd freak me out.
Sound alerts, yep.
Yes.
That sounds awful. I know the people in my stream would always, especially when I'm playing something scary, would always do the scare alerts on me, and it's the worst. Okay, so what is the scariest game you've ever played?
I don't know, I feel like, okay, so there's different levels of scared. So like, there's like just straight up jump scares, and then there's games that like, like psychologically scared me.
Ooh.
If it's like jump scares, just like frequency, probably like Five Nights at Freddy's. because it's
okay.
It's like quick. You're constantly like got like a high heart rate because you don't want to get scared, and then ultimately you probably will. And it's like that jump scare, but like actually scary. And this is gonna sound ridiculous. So on Dreamcast, there's this game called Omicron, and for some reason, the way the game is set up, it's like you're in this world, and if you die in the game, then you'll die in like the world, which to me translated to like me dying in the real world. And my sister told me when I was little, like if I got a game over in Mario, I would die in real life. And so I'd always turn it off, right?
Oh my God. You think that would never happen
to me again. Yeah. You think as a I don't know, Dreamcast, so what, I'm in maybe high school, maybe ninth grade? And this game, Omicron, made me believe that if we died while playing the game, we would die in real life. And that is like the most scared that I've ever been while being of like reasonable mind.
Mm-hmm.
Terrifying.
Oh my God.
But I do recommend playing it. That's a hell of a game. We're sleeping on Omicron.
Maybe I might have to do that on my stream.
I don't know if people want to watch that game.
So I finished playing Outlast and I'm in the middle of playing Whistleblower. So I'm switching between Whistleblower and Biohazard. It's like, I don't know which one's more scary because either I can run and hide in Outlast or I actually have to fight these things in Resident Evil. It's like, I don't know what's scarier. Like,
yeah. Outlast is very, it's real messed up.
Yeah, I hate it. Like, even when I started playing Whistleblower, I'm like, okay, this isn't going to be too bad because they're at least with real people. But no.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, you're like, this could possibly be worse.
Yeah.
So then, you don't like scary games. When you watch scary movies, you got to have a friend with you. But are you into horror? Like, if you're with a person, would you like offer up the idea to watch a horror movie, or do you kind of just get roped in?
Yes. I love horror. Like every year, this is gonna be the first year, thanks to COVID, that I'm missing Halloween Horror Nights. But I love horror as long as I'm not alone. So like, Shayna and Keith will come with us to Halloween Horror Nights just because they love seeing me and Jessamyn Duke run, scream, jump, hide, all of that. And it's just, I don't know. It's nice to know that like, okay, at least these people won't let anything happen to us, but I just love the thrill of it.
Yeah.
I think, like I said, that's why I've never really played scary games. It's like, I'm not playing this by myself.
Yeah.
But now it's like, oh, I love it.
Horror Nights is great. You're good. I got one. Yes. So I went, I guess the past like two or three years. Because my favorite one was when they did when they were doing The Purge over by The Mummy.
Yes.
Oh, so awesome.
The first time I went was, I think they just started doing The Walking Dead. So they had zombies. And you know how they have like scare zones? Mm-hmm. For this year, they actually had the whole park like just be immersed with zombies.
Oh my God.
So you didn't have like a zone to get away from, which was the best Halloween Horror Nights experience ever for me. Yeah. But like when they did The Purge was my second favorite. Mm-hmm. But it was just like, I love Halloween Horror Nights.
Yeah.
It's just so much fun to go with a good group.
Oh yeah, group is definitely gonna make it a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
Get your peoples, because there's things where like you said, you get scared and they laugh at you, but then when they finally get scared, big pop from you.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm still waiting on Keith to get his scare. He's too busy laughing at us.
It's gonna come one day. Nobody's gonna realize it's gonna hit him hard and he's gonna freak out.
Yep. Can't wait.
Yeah, that's been like a staple of my quarantine life has been horror movies. I'm obsessed to the point where I'm just watching everything and I don't care if I've got people with me or not. It's this is gonna sound like an ad. So Shudder is this thing, it's like Netflix for horror movies, and it's legit become my favorite streaming service because it's just
Shudder?
Horror. Yeah, Shudder.
I've heard of that. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have to get in. Okay, but do they have like Asian horror movies?
Yeah, they've got everything.
Okay. I'm
the
sold.
Only thing that we noticed. So like a bunch of the movies are subtitled because they're in different languages because other countries just understand horror better than we do in the States.
Yeah.
But then I heard a lot of them aren't available on the US servers. Like if you get like a VPN and do it like through the UK or something, you'll have access to more movies. I guess in the States, ooh, they don't want us to see it.
Of course. Of course.
Do you have a favorite horror movie?
My favorite horror movie would probably be The Ringu.
Oh, yep. Yep.
I love like Asian horror movies, like especially Japanese horror movies.
Yep.
I watched it as a kid with my mom. It was like this Korean horror flick. I just remember the ghost in it. Like she looked like the Ringu chick, but like, I don't remember the name, but it was this Korean scary movie and it was traumatized me as a child, but not enough because I still love it. I would say The Ringu is probably my ultimate favorite scary movie.
It's a hell of a movie.
Oh my God.
It's always interesting to see, because did you see like the American one first?
I saw the Japanese version first and then the American, but I think that's also why I didn't care for the American version.
Yeah. Because like I saw the American version first and then I watched it and I thought it was dope. But then when I saw Ringu, I was like, oh, it's supposed to be like this?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
It's probably a good way to watch it is the American version than the Asian version, just because American scary movies don't touch. They don't touch the Asian scary movies, man.
Yeah, there's some good stuff. So like, I'm like a big fan of like Paranormal Activity and like the Conjuring universe and how they're like building that out, especially with like La Llorona, and they're adding all these things in. But like, there's just something about other countries and horror. They get it.
Yeah.
They get it.
Yeah, they do. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so in closing, last question is, if you could cosplay as any video game character for your WrestleMania entrance, what character would that be?
That's a great question. Honestly, I would love, like I said, I'm not a fan of Western anything, but if I could just come out to a Red Dead theme, be Sadie Adler, hell, or even Lenny. I would love to be Lenny. Lenny or Sadie Adler on a horse with a cowboy hat. Oh, man, and like a Westernized version. I don't even know how they would do it, but a Westernized version of my theme song. I would love to just come out with a horse as Sadie Adler and Prince Stannis walking along my horse. That would probably be my ideal.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you heard her. So if we can get that Western Mia Yim remix, just go ahead and tweet it at her. What you can tell.
It's about to have sure a little bump. Flavor of hip hop though.
Yeah, it's gotta still bump. It can't just be that twangy stuff. It's gotta have some bump to it. Put the made 08s in it.
I gotta have my Arabian horse as well. It's gotta be my Arabian.
Oh, there we go. See, just killing it. So y'all make it happen. Y'all make this woman's dreams come true. Help her out some.
Rockstar, I love you.
Yes, and you know the deal, guys. Tweet these people. Let them know the link between them and WWE. This is the link. Video games.
Hey.
Mia, unfortunately, that's all the time we have. Oh, you know what I didn't do? You know what I did not do? I'm the worst at this. This is my gimmick now. What's your up, up, down, down name?
Maybe, I don't remember what my nickname was.
I don't know.
My nickname is the Shelton Slayer.
The Shelton Slayer. That's perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank the Shelton Slayer for being on.
Hey.
Where can they find you on social?
On social, you can find me on Twitter at Mia Yim, Instagram, Mia Yim Official, on Twitch, it's me, Mia Yim, YouTube, Mia Yim Official, and I think on Facebook, it's WWE Mia Yim.
All the links will be in the description below down there. Thank you so much for being on. We appreciate your time.
Thank you so much for having me. And I'm just going to keep dying.
It's fine. We're done anyway. We're done anyway. You guys know where to find me at Xavier Woods PhD, Twitter, Instagram. Make sure you check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/AustinCreed. If you like this episode, which I know you did, go tell your friends, go tell your homies how fantastic Mia Yim is and send them the link to this so they can be a part of the joy as well. And until next time, make sure you guys always and forever keep it tight. Da 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 da